Well, hello there, boys. It's me. How do I stay in dreams? You have encountered a superb guide for runs KPHK scripting. Here I will try to explain how to make a failure-proof script. We have a Discord server, in which you can seek for help regarding scripting. Download links for files and templates will be in description. By the order of the Fucking Goon Squad, let's begin. To make a good script, you need to think about what makes scripts break. Most common reason, you are writing linear scripts that need to follow your precise flow of actions. Let's say, your script encounters lag in game, for up to 5 seconds, it goes out of sync, thus breaking. Other reason, you don't use indicators that tell you that you have hovered over an object or NPC. You will need to use OpenOSRS Launcher and modified No More AHKs plugins. Now, why No More AHKs plugins? Because you can mark the center of an object with a tiny square. Then you can randomize coordinates around that square. First, we need to understand how PixelSearch works. It has 9 parameters. First two, px and py, are first pixel's coordinates, at which color is found. Third to sixth parameters define a rectangle, in which to search for color. Seventh parameter is color code, which starts with 0x. Eighth parameter is variation. 0 means no variation, search for exact color, to 255, all colors. It's okay to use 1 for variation. Ninth parameter is mode, we will use fast RGB. There are 6 colors with which you can mark objects. There is also black and white, but those don't work too well. Maybe that's just me. How do we define that rectangle in which to search for pixel? We can use AHK's built-in program, called Window Spy. Make sure you make the window active, in which you want to search. I use the default values. Get top left and bottom right coordinates. Then, enter what color you want to search from this list and mark the objects with respective colors. Now, if pixel search is successful and finds color in our defined rectangle, it will return pixel coordinates to px, py and error level 0. If unsuccessful, it will return error level 1. I like to use 0, meaning indicator is false, and 1, meaning indicator is found. As you can see in this function, we set variable to 0, then if pixel search is successful, setting that variable to 1 and returning value. We will need to make that variable global, in the start of script, so it can be reached from outside the function. In the main loop, we need to call that function, to keep updating our variable. For woodcutting, there is plugin, which says in green and red text whether you are woodcutting. Now, if our character is not woodcutting, and inventory is not full, proceed to cut. Let's check the cut function. It searches for color blue, with which we marked our object. If blue is found, then mouse over, and call function is hovered. It will update global variable. If hovered, do actions. It is exactly here, what reduces script breaking probability to bare minimum. Now, let's say some unforeseen circumstances occur. Would those circumstances be possible to make a giant green square to appear in exact location? No. Because it will only appear when our marked object is hovered. Our character won't do any actions, stay AFK and will be logged out. Now let's see how pixel search that waits for color would look like. In this function, earlier we have clicked on a bank booth, and here we are waiting for orange text bank of Jaelena to appear. Meaning our character has reached bank. Pixel search is constantly looping and returning error level 1, while color is not found in a specific area. If error level 0 returned, only then we start doing our actions. After all actions, break infinite loop. You can scan a large area for colors you are using to mark objects. This allows you to use an antiban arrow left, arrow right. If you only use one camera angle, your mouse movements recording will draw a pattern, showing that mouse moves only in defined paths. If we change camera angle, our script will do the same thing, but mouse will move across more various paths than using static camera angle. Some more anti-ban suggestions. Implement random mouse movements, mouse movement with right click and move up. Make it sometimes check stats. Sometimes long sleeps, like 8 to 20 seconds with inactive launcher window. I suggest using WindHumanMouse for more anti-ban. But I reckon you would be just fine, if using all above antibans, even using random Bezier or stock mouse move. I suggest using large screen window, because, I believe, it is easier for Jagex to track mouse movements in smaller area. Use entity hider and hide other players and NPCs that are not needed. Randomize your coordinates, sleep variables, don't script for prolonged periods of time, especially if it's a fresh account. Level your combat stats, don't go for only one skill. Another thing, I wouldn't suggest leaving scripts overnight. Because Jagex can see your local IP address, meaning they know your local time. Who in their right mind would sit overnight playing their shitty game? Then get up, eat some biscuits with tea, take a shit and play some more during the day. While other goblin boys are using bots, paying for VPN and premium scripts with their mom's credit card and still get banned after several days, we can put our beautiful minds into our scripts, and make it undetectable even using our home IP address. Thank you for watching and good luck.